the late turn game plan just to make sure B is the more important point to defend, but I mean, Cammy right now doing it literally all himself. Every single kill for his team this round has been him. This is the man OpTic needs to stop.
Welcome to Down the Sights with Toronto Ultra, presented by Jack Lynx. It's a breakdown series that explains in-game decisions, tactical plays, and game-changing moments. For this episode, we're looking back on the OpTic Chicago series in Losers Round 5. This series was a nail-biter, and for the breakdown, we'll dive into the raid control. So with that said, let's get into it and go down the sights. We're heading into Round 5 on this control map, and because OpTic has collected more ticks of progress on the control zones, we have offense. For our Round 5 offense, an important decision needs to be made off the rip. Do we attack the more difficult zone at B and throw our opponents off guard, or do we attack A, the easier zone to get set up in? Ultra decides to be safer and set up a standard hit towards A, and right away, a massive moment happens. Three Ultra players actually drop, but because of Cammy, the A push is still alive. If Cammy found no kills or got traded, Toronto would have had difficulty winning this map since Insight died pool house and the rest of the team was coming off spawn, meaning we had zero map control and would have had to expend lives in order to regain it. However, luckily we have a human turret and Cammy saves the play and allows the team to get set up in the zone, and we managed to capture it early, giving us over 2 minutes of time to work with. The difficulty now is transitioning onto the other side of the map, since OpTic conceded the zone and will have the initial setup. There is a massive win condition in this very moment though. Cammy's insane opening actually puts him close to streaks, so the game plan for now is to get Cammy streaks so we have an easier time closing this one out. Streaks are secured, and the next step is gaining control of the pool house, which unlocks the close spawn to B so support can get there faster. We deal with Scump, and Bance, who originally pushed through the back with Cammy, has basketball control, and posting up in the corner secures a two-piece the same time Scump dies in pool house. Ultra, knowing the whole team just went down, means we can stack the zone, call in the streaks, and make sure no one from OpTic can get a touch on the zone in time. Ultra managed to secure the zone and bring home the 3-2 victory. The three key takeaways from episode 11 are: 1. In control, know when to chalk the zone. Giving over an extra minute is never ideal, but in a lot of cases it's necessary to make sure you get set up at the new zone first. 2. Playing for streaks on offense is important around the map pools for control, but make sure you're not taking too much time to get them since you're already limited on time in this game mode. And 3. Clear parts of the map together. More map control usually means closer spawns since they are no longer being blocked, and trying to do that on your own isn't always going to work. Wait for your teammates and hit it together. This was our 13th control win in a row, a massive upgrade from the 2-8 record we had in stage 1. We went on to beat OpTic in a game 5 round 11, but fell short in the following round against FaZe, giving us a third place finish for the third major.